Lisa. Hi. Hello. Shalom. What's good? What it is? What's good? Hi. Hello. Annyeonghaseyo. You know what it is. Annyeonghaseyo. That joke is so dead, but oh well. Hello. Hello, hello, hello. 안녕하세요. 알렉사입니다. What's good? So I'm home right now. I had the clubhouse thing this morning. Great time. So grateful to Alexis and Lai for the wonderful experience. Would definitely love to do it again. And thank you for those of you that hopped in and asked questions. I always love talking to you guys directly. It's quite fun because even though we have wonderful things like Vlive and I can see your comments and everything, it's always nice to actually be able to talk to you guys. But I'm just here for a little break before I do my next schedule. Just chilling, listening to some tunes. I'm gonna turn that up so it's quiet. How's my ankle? My ankle is getting better. For those of you that may or may not know, I had a stage on Tuesday. God hates me. I'll come to terms with it. Are you done? Thank you. Okay. Well, God hates me. Anyways, I had a stage on Tuesday for the LGU event. LGU Adora For You Live. It was me and Victon Sambenim and Ace Sambenim and Cravity. It was the four of us and we did this event. So I did Revolution, I did Villain, I did Moon and Back, and Never Let You Go. That being said, I did have to dance. And my ankle, it was/is getting okay. It's getting better, but definitely having danced on it, it kind of took it two steps back. It hurts a little bit more than it did, but I assure you I'm fine. It'll get better. But yeah. 저는 화요일? Yeah? 화요일에 저는 빅톤 선배님이랑 에이스 선배님이랑 크래비티님들 저랑 그 아돌라 LGU 플러스 아돌라 For You 페스티벌 참여하게 되어서 거기서 저는 레볼루션 무대하고 필런 무대하고 문 앤 백 하고 오랜만이야 그 세 곡 다 했었습니다. My ankle. There's so many things I want to do but I can't do because my freaking ankle, but it is what it is. But did y'all by chance see Good Morning? Speaking is very difficult today for some reason. Did y'all see the video that we put up with Sunny Tahe? Sunny is literally the sweetest, the cutest. I love her, I adore her. I really hope we can collab again in the future because she's just like the best. I'm gonna take a drink of this grapefruit water real quick. Y'all, does this happen to anybody else? Like if you don't sleep for like a long while, like your stomach gets upset? Because that's with me. If I don't sleep well for like days, my stomach is like, you want to function? That's a funny joke. It's a funny joke. I don't even like grapefruit. Poor decisions, one of many. Let's see, I'm just here to chill with y'all. That's basically what I'm doing. My hair, oh, it's a mess. I literally just showered last night, let it dry. I don't use a blow dryer. And I just threw in a ponytail because it's meh, but thanks. Glad y'all like my hair. My roots are so grown out, though. Oh my god, my roots are so grown out. Y'all, what color should I go next? Like, I want to know what y'all think I should go next. Personally, I want to go, like, pink or dark blue. But like, that's just me. Let's see. Want to be my sleep paralysis demon? Sure, I will gladly be your sleep paralysis demon. I'll just stand in the corner of your room like, aha, what's up? But yeah, let's see. Can we get an awa awa? Not today. Not today. Oh, hello, sweetie. Please calm down. This song is a little too much for the mood right now. I'm not in the mood for this right now. Broken. There we go. Yellow. Okay, but are we talking like neon yellow, like highlighter, tennis ball yellow, or like canary yellow? Because there's a difference. Te amo. We just talked on Clubhouse. Hello, yes. Anybody here that I did get to speak to on Clubhouse today, hello again. Good to see you again. I am like dead inside and out right now. That's on. Fatigue. Neon green. Fun fact, Revolution, when we were getting the swatches of like hair dye options for Revolution, we had the mint. We had like a more cyan tone, and then we had like this bright neon green, and I was like, what if? But clearly we did not do that. Thoughts on Attack on Titan? I was just talking about Attack on Titan yesterday. I'm not up to date. Please, no spoilers. No spoiler. I already know what's going on though, because I see things on social media, but yeah, I haven't started the new season yet, but, Attack on Titan, y'all. Like, I will catch myself walking around my house, and I'll just be, like, singing anime intros, and, like, the other day, and I'm not joking, I wish I could make this up. I slammed my hip into the table that I have over here, and I just yelled, like, Sasage! This is why I don't have friends. Anyways, Hiromiya, nope. Do not know what that is. Only the just on Mian Mian Ani. Quintana. Let's see. Recommend some animes. I haven't watched anything new in a while, that's the thing. Like, I started watching I don't know what the title is, because I know what it is in Korean, but I don't know what it is in English, but it's like Cooking Wars. I don't know, it was like these people, they're cooking, and it's dramatic, and it's a cooking show. I like watching it because I can't cook, so you know, like, let's see. I've heard a lot about The Promised Neverland, actually. I've heard it's good. It's probably something I would read slash watch, because it seems like it's pretty macabre. Food Wars! Yay! My brain said Iron Chef. That is not what that is, but yeah. Oh, geez. Let's see. Chopped. Onnihaku juseyo. Say hello to my friend Juanita. Hello, Juanita. Hello. Favorite K-drama? I've always said it's Park Tae's Hajunun Yeppun Yoja or Something in the Rain. Because the dynamic is just, how do I have that? But recently, I really don't watch a lot of dramas, but recently I'd say Sweet Home, because that's just like up my alley of things that I like. Did y'all notice that the creature in Sweet Home, the one that has like half of its head cut off, looks really similar to the son of Satan in Constantine, the Keanu Reeves movie? Did y'all notice that? Or is that just me? But Let's see. Everything's going by real fast today. Wow. How your hair look healthy. That's the thing. It's really not. It's really not, I promise. Honestly, it's dead. It's dead. I try to take care of it, but at the end of the day, it's dead. I take pictures, and then, like, when I look at them, I'm like, I see, like, all these little, like, frizzies happening because my hair's, like, broken. But, haha, it is what it is. Yeah, it's not healthy. Trust me, one of my friends constantly loves to remind me how dead my hair is. So, Let's see. My poor scalp. My scalp is fine. It's just my hair that is not. What if I shaved my head? Like, what if? I just kind of want to chop everything off. Yo, don't contend, yo. Yo, don't contend, senita. No, don't contend, huh? Let's see. Sleep schedule is non-existent. My circadian rhythm is completely thrown off. Sleep is not something I do. We are very distant friends that see each other on rare occasions. But I'm managing. Boycott? I mean, yeah, I don't know if, well, meh. When I was 17 years old, I had a pixie cut. Like, really, really short pixie cut. Like, think of whatever, like, male idol, like, short dude cut. I had that length of hair for a while. And, like, I like having short hair, but the problem is when it grows out. Because it grows out so awkwardly. Because, like, it doesn't grow into, like, a bob. It grows into, like, a circle. And it's just, like... So if I were to cut my hair short, maintaining it would be a pain in the butt. But, it's hard to say. Do I have any saved on my phone / iPad? Let's find out. Let's see. You were a coconut for a point in time. For a point in time, I was a coconut. But, like, that was high school. And then I cut my hair short again when I started college. But, like, it is what it is. Do I have any pictures, though? That's the real question. Do I have pictures? I haven't updated my library in a while. Shoot, I gotta upload more stuff back on here. I don't think I have any pictures. Yeah, I don't, but I will try to find some and show you guys next time. But I had very short hair for a point in time, and I liked it. Want to do it again, but it's also at this point I've grown my hair out so long. Because y'all know when I was on Produce, I had like basically take one ponytail. It was like this length when I started Produce, and it's grown out a lot. So are these my natural nails? No, they're extensions, and they're very grown out at the moment. I really need to get them redone, but. Get a wolf cut. Yo, listen, I actually want to get a wolf cut so bad. Like, I mean, we had some wonderful ladies bring back the mullet last year, and they looked chef's kiss. But I don't think many girls have done the wolf cut yet. Because back in the day, Boa Samenim, she actually, like, popularized it a little bit. She had the wolf cut. I kind of want to do it. But again, it's cutting off hair, and I grew this out after so long. Okay, Evanescence, that's a little too emo for me right now. Sure, Green Day. Okay. Red hair? If anybody is good at, like, Photoshop, I am, like, begging you, please, Photoshop me. I did see someone do a mullet, so much thanks for that. I would ask that you Photoshop me with, like, dark blue hair, with, like, pink hair, red hair. And, like, if anybody wants to attempt to Photoshop a half shave, like, basically the Skrillex hair that we had back in the day. Because I've always wanted to shave half my head, at least. But never had the chance to. But I really want to do it, so. Bleach blonde hair. That's basically what my hair is, honestly. Like, it shows up different on camera. But my hair is really not as white as it is, I promise. It's actually kind of blonde still at the ends. And not gonna lie, it's like greenish still because it's like stained from the mint that we use for Evolution. I have to use red shampoo to get out the green, but it doesn't really work. RIP. It's the first time that I see one of your lives. Well, hello. Welcome. Welcome. Let's see. Sorry that I'm not translating as much today. My brain is just like, you can barely speak English today. Don't you dare attempt Korean. So I said, okay. 오늘은 번역 많이 안 했으니까 죄송합니다. 오늘은 그냥 영어는 좀 어려운데 그래서 한국말로 번역하는 게 더 어려울 것 같아서 안 합니다. Oh my gosh. 한국에서 온 김준홍입니다. Our CEO Marty is in the chat. 안녕하십니까 대표님, 와주셔서 감사합니다. Wow. But yeah, let's see. What color should you paint your nails? Black. I want to turn these into black because the red was nice while it lasted, but it's. I just want to go back to black. Liv says, sorry if I annoyed you during Clubhouse. Not at all. No, no, no. Me getting to talk to you guys makes me happy. I'm sorry if I annoy you on Clubhouse, if I accidentally overspoke over you or anything. No, not at all. Y'all were a blast. Y'all were a joy to talk to. So don't worry, you pretty little head. Horror movie recommendations. Yes. Let's see. I recently watched, I think I said this last time, but I'm going to say it again. Midsommar. Midsommar. Listen, listen. If you are underage, do not watch it. There are inappropriate things that you should not watch if you are not an adult. Language, whatever. We hear it, but like certain things you just shouldn't see if you're underage. But it's odd. It's a really, really weird movie. But it's so good. Like, it's kind of like a car crash. Like, you feel like you shouldn't be looking at it, but like you can't take your eyes away from it. Like, the plot is actually very predictable, in my opinion. I figured out the entire plot within like the first few minutes of the movie, and I wasn't wrong. But it's definitely well shot, well filmed, and there's several little Easter eggs and hints within the movie that, like, if you catch them, it's kind of like, yo, like there's little things in the film. It's just really cool. But it's definitely an inappropriate film for children and like young teenagers. I do not recommend it. But if you are an adult and you like horror movies, I highly recommend Midsommar. But I will say if you're sensitive to gore, if you're sensitive to if you're easily triggered by things, don't watch it. Yeah? Yeah? I was trying to give things that weren't spoilers, but if you're just easily triggered by things, don't watch it. But Midsommar is really good. Again, there's this movie called Cadaver on Netflix. I think it's originally from the Netherlands. I don't know. But that one's also pretty good. 10 out of 10. Recommend. Also, predictable plot, but it's good. Let's see. You're gonna cut your hair today. Yeah, I would love to join you. Watching someone else get their hair cut, it's kind of like therapeutic because I want to cut mine so bad. Bestie, have you watched Howl's Moving Castle? Of course I have, y'all! Look at me. If I were to just braid this back, y'all, I am Sophie. Where is my Howl? Where is my Howl? Yes, I love Howl's Moving Castle. It is my all-time favorite Studio Ghibli movie, actually. All-time favorite. Let's see. What dance should you learn today? I mean, in honor of it being the year anniversary of AI Trooper's release, you could try to learn AI Trooper, but it's a little difficult. I mean, even I had problems when I was learning it, but try to learn AI Trooper, maybe. Yeah. Let's see. Can I edit your head bald? Yeah, I mean, maybe not like smooth bald, but like shaved. Yeah, if you guys can Photoshop that, I would low-key love to see what I would look like with a shaved head. This is like the weirdest request. Like, I'm probably the idol that makes the weirdest requests for their fans. I like your shirt. Thank you. It is literally a t-shirt that I cut into a crop top. Jackie Laura hair. Oh my gosh, like so black with like the pink highlights. Listen, I wanted to go black and then do colored highlights, but I feel like the trend isn't around anymore. Not that I care, because we're just gonna do what we wanna do with ZB. But I wanna do something with dark hair again, because as you can tell, my roots have grown out horribly at this point. Oh my gosh, the Girl Scout song from Beetlejuice musical. Yeah, my roots are so grown out. Like, if you look at me, it looks like I have white, it looks like I'm wearing like a black headband because my roots are so grown out. I need to get my roots touched up. Let's see, milk or cereal first? Cereal. Cereal first. You do not put milk first. Do you put water in before you put your plant in? No. Undercut. Low key, I really want to undercut. Like, when I first started getting into Attack on Titan in high school, like, I looked at Levi and I was like, yeah, I want that. But it never happened, clearly. But I low-key kind of want to get an undercut. Summer or winter? I don't know. I don't know. I like summer fashion more than winter fashion. But, like, in terms of like living conditions, winter, because in the summer you can only take off so much before you want to peel off your skin, but at least in the winter you can put on more and more layers. So yeah. Hola Argentina, hola to Argentina, home of J6. He likes to always bring up that he was born in Argentina. Let's see. Ponyo! I do love Ponyo! I remember seeing it in theaters. Oh, it's so cute. I love Ghibli animation. It's just something about it is just very nostalgic for me when I watch it. It's just Microwave Queen. That's me. Let's see. You're starting university in a week. Any advice? Make sure you have your priorities straight. Yeah? Keep your priorities in line. Like, if you got work to get done, do your work. Don't procrastinate. I'm someone that was a really bad procrastinator in school. I always did things last minute. It worked for me, but I don't recommend it for other people. Don't procrastinate. Let's see. Who would you play in Beetlejuice? That's a great question. Listen. I mean, Winona Ryder as Lydia, that is like one of my all-time favorite movie roles, but musical wise Lydia would be fun. But like, I really would love to do the Delia / Mish Argentina role, but as I am not of like Latina or Hispanic descent, I clearly could not play the role. But it would be such a fun role to do the Delia and Miss Argentina role, because Delia's numbers and Delia's character, I think Delia is my favorite character in the musical. Not in the movie, because it's a very different dynamic that the dad and Delia have in the movie. But in the musical, Delia is my favorite character. I love her. Protect Delia at all costs. I mean, Barbara would be fun too. But also just being part of the ensemble, honestly, because the choreography is so cool and you have so many different costumes and characters. I don't know. I think it would just be fun to be in that musical. But we all know it's not playing anymore on Broadway. Rest in peace, Beetlejuice musical. Let's see. Hola, Mexico. Favorite current song? Okay, not gonna lie. I downloaded a bunch of Nicki Minaj albums the other day because I haven't listened to Nicki in a while, and I was like, okay, let me re-download everything I had on my iPhone, like, back in high school. I've been listening to the Pink Friday album on a loop, and at this point, I think I know every word to Roman Holiday, and I am not ashamed of that. Roman Holiday is, like, it's my alarm in the morning. So, I don't know, I guess just the Pink Friday album by Nicki Minaj, I've been listening to that a lot lately. Gives me so many memories, because I remember when, like, those songs first came out, and it's just like, wow, it's been a while, but Roman Holiday, man. Let's see, Nicki Minaj, best rapper. She is incredible. She is incredible. And I wish that people would stop referring to her as a female rapper and just as a rapper in general, because that's what she is. She's a rapper. Yeah, she's a woman, but, like, being a woman rapper is the same as being a rapper. There needs to be some more respect on that, but... And yes, Megan Thee Stallion, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Crybaby, I really love the aesthetics for the music video. Really loved it. And Cardi B with Up recently, too. So many wonderful, incredible women are making such great music lately, and it's... Let's see. Can you say hi to my kitten, Jetta? Jetta? Hi, Jetta. Meow, meow. Hi, Jetta. But, movie recommendations. Movie recommendations. What are... hair? Y'all, I have bangs, but I never wear them down because they just... meh. Movie recommendations, but tangent with this song. So, on Tuesday with the Adorla For You LG Plus event that I did with Ace, Sumbanium, and then the other two groups. When I was coming off my stage, Ace, Sumbanium was like the closing act, so they were after me. So as I was going off stage, they were entering, of course. And I was getting my, like, mic pack taken off and everything. And then this song started and I was just like, turn me up so they can hear this louder. It was hype. I was hype for all of 10 seconds and then I had to leave. But, anyways, movie recommendations. Movie recommendations. What have I watched recently? I was kind of on, like, my Tilda Swinton... I was riding the Tilda Swinton wave, and so we watched Constantine because, of course, she is Gabriel, and that, it's a fantastic movie. And then, the one with Ezra Miller. We need to talk about Kevin. She's also incredible in that movie. And then, I was gonna start watching, my brain, do not do the thing sometimes, but... I guess I would recommend Constantine, and we need to talk about Kevin. If you enjoy Tilda Swinton and Keanu Reeves and Ezra Miller, then good movies. Good movies. Yeah. Hi, Chelsea. My name's Chelsea. What's your favorite dinner food? Alexa, I'm scared to come out to everyone. Any advice? I know that a few of you have asked me these things before. Again, it's not really my position to tell you what you should do because I am not in your shoes. But, you know, just know at the end of the day, it's your choice. No one should ever... sorry, let's go fall. No one should ever make you come out as a threat. You know, come out when you feel like it and when you feel safe. That's the thing. I know that some people choose not to come out because they don't feel safe. Whether it's their environment or the people around them. But again, it's your choice. And just make sure that you feel safe. Don't feel pressured into it. That's the best advice I can offer, I suppose. You're trying to choose between fashion or music. Why not both? Why not both? I mean, I guess you know, they could kind of tie into each other. They could kind of tie into each other because... it could be a visual thing, like you could, you know, you could keep doing music and maybe design your own outfits. Like if you were to shoot a music video for yourself, what would you wear? What does this song look like to you? You know, you could do both. Why not? Hi, Alex. I'm Noah, and I love you so much. Hello, Noah. Hola, Bren. Hola, Bren. Hello. It's your birthday. Happy birthday. My style inspiration? Good question. Style inspiration. I don't think there's any person in specific, but I really like tech wear. I like grunge. Not gonna lie, I'm really living for the bimbo aesthetic that's going on TikTok, specifically Chrissy. I don't know how to pronounce her last name, so I'm not gonna try, but Chrissy, she is my queen. I love her. But like makeup wise, I get a lot of inspiration from her. My zodiac, you're a Sagittarius. I'm a Sagittarius. Oh my gosh, Sagittarius friends. My favorite dinosaur? My favorite dinosaur. I don't quite think I have one. I do know that I'm scared of them if they were to ever exist again. I don't know, just big reptiles with teeth. No. No. A collab with Chrissy. No, but really, she's my queen. Like, when I go on my For You page and I see her TikToks, I always watch them because she's so beautiful and funny. I love her. I love what she stands for. I love her. Let's see. Alice in Borderland. Yes, I have watched part of it. Let's see. Favorite color is black. Yes. How's your ankle, Missy? Hello, Katie. Again, it's getting better. I want to say maybe by the end of next week, I should be like at least 100%. Maybe not 100, but at least 90. I was at about 75%, and then I danced on it, and now I'm kind of back to 60. Because it's still quite painful to walk. And I shouldn't be doing a lot of things that I've been doing, but ankle, whatever. It's let's see, what's Clubhouse? So from what I've gathered from looking around on the app a bit, basically it is like public conference calls, like where the admin will grant who's able to talk and who's not able to, but like strangers can join club room, and listen in on your conversation. So, I mean, I know people are doing, like, TED Talks and everything on there. People are doing, like, therapy sessions, advice corners. Yeah, but the thing is, you can only get on the app by invite. That's the thing. So, yeah. You posted the red dark blue on Twitter already? Huh? Y'all fast. I don't have Twitter on my iPad, but I'm gonna just chrome it. We're gonna chrome it. Twitter. Yeah, I'm gonna figure it out. I should really download Twitter on my iPad. Why haven't I downloaded Twitter by now? What is our login? You know what? I'll just check it after. I'll check it after. But thank you for the edits. I will be keeping my eyes peeled for that. Hello, Audrey. Yes, we met today during the Clubhouse and then during the Airbnb for Zoom. Yes. Hello, hello. Let's see. When will we get a light stick? That is a great question that I do not know the answer to, but hopefully sometime within the year. I don't know. Yeah. Yeah. Let's see. I want to tattoo your name on my forehead. Bold statement. Very Joker-esque of you. I'm not gonna say don't do that because I can't tell you how to live your life, but like twice somebody named once said, better think about it twice. Don't tattoo my name on your forehead, please. Turn that song up. Well, in fact, well, I look at it this way. I mean, technically, our marriage is safe. Well, this calls for a toast, so pour the champagne. Y'all. Nah, never mind. Let's see. Alexa, a once confirmed. We love to see it. No, guys, I am a once. I am completely a once. I absolutely adore Twice. Somebody named. I really, really love Twice. Like, if you guys go back to when they first debuted, I actually sent in my cover of Uahage to the After School Club fan cover submissions, and I got accepted, so I was played in the episode. If you want to check that out, little pre-debut Alexa with her blonde short hair. But no, y'all, since the beginning, I am a certified once. Y'all, I watched 16 and everything. I respect those girls so much. Oh, to be twice. That would be the collab of, like, the century in my brain. But I would love, personally, I would really love to do a dance stage with Momo Sunbaenim, because she is such an incredible dancer. She's someone I really look up to in the industry as a female. Like, her dance video she put out recently, immaculate. So, much respect to Twist. Let's see. You're the first person I'm coming out to. Oh my gosh, congratulations. Honored, very honored. Thank you for coming out in our little VLive time together. Thank you. Congratulations, I'm glad that you are comfortable in your own skin to be yourself. Congratulations. Let's see. My favorite snack food for movies. Well, it depends on what movie theater I would go to. Because some movie theaters, I was like, pretzels. Some movie theaters, I was like, hot dogs. And then some movie theaters, it's just popcorn and like Twizzlers. But no, Regina Spector, not today. I no sad time, please. Twice, thank you. Hello? Thank you. Yeah. Alexa, do you know what Do You Listen to Girl in Red means? Yes, I know what that means. And I know what sweater weather means. You guys, remember, I'm American. I get these jokes. I'm also a child of the internet. Granted, I'm not exactly a Gen Z, but I know what you guys are talking about. I know these things. Let's see. Oh, I forgot I covered this pre-debut. When I was at the 1997 studio, I did covers for them like once a month. And then when Fancy first came out, I covered it. Let's see. Motivation for school. Motivation for school. Here's the thing. I know school's not for everyone. I'm not telling you to drop out, but I'm not gonna be the person that says you need to go to school, because I know it's not for everyone. But, I mean, I personally wish I could have finished college and gotten my degree. But, you know, coincidentally, I wound up doing this. But, again, I said this to someone earlier about their exams and because they're gonna enter college. Don't procrastinate. At the end of the day, the last thing you wanna do is have a bunch of work piled up to do last minute when you could have tackled it. Like, instead of sitting on your phone on TikTok for 4 hours, do your science homework. Like, come on. So, don't procrastinate. Yeah. Yeah, you found the UA video? Yeah, I think when I was submitting things for After School Club, I got on for UA Hage by twice. I know I submitted for other things, but I don't remember what I got on. I know I've actually been on the dance cover portion like a few times, but I don't remember. Hopefully one of these days I will go on After School Club and people will cover my songs. One of these days. Oh, that's gonna be so cathartic. So cathartic, oh my gosh. I look tired, I am. I'm not gonna sit here and lie to you and say that I'm bright and shiny. I'm tired, but I'm fine. I'm happy and I'm here with y'all. So that's what makes me happy. Let's see. Do I listen to Mamamoo? Of course I listen to Mamamoo Sonbaenim's. Of course I do. Of course I do. Oh, to have their vocal skills. Oh, to have, but like, just a crumb of their vocal skills. But that's what we're gonna work hard for, so. Hello to Samantha, Sarah, and Jamie. Hello. Shalom. Are you still friends with Dreamcatcher? Yeah, I am. Dreamcatcher, somebody named. Ah, yeah. If you guys haven't been following the recent comeback, please do. Yes. My girls, they look so good. They're doing such a good job. I'm so proud of them. I love hyping my friends when they make comebacks. It's just like, look at you go. That's my best friend. Like, like, as someone that grew up like dancing and singing and performing and everything, it's always just so nice to have friends that do the same thing you do so you can hype them up. I don't know, it's just nice. But advice on singing better. I don't feel like I am the person to ask, but I will provide you with a tidbit of advice, and that is don't try to sing songs that are out of your range, because the more strain that you put in your voice, the more damage you're gonna cause. And at the end of the day, like, I don't know, 10 years down the line, maybe you won't be able to sing like how you used to be able to because you kept straining your voice. So I don't know, stay hydrated. If you have any kind of singing event like the next day, this is a weird tip, but I learned this in choir. Don't drink milk the night before. I'm lactose intolerant, so I do not mess with milk anyways, but because it just coats your throat weirdly, so don't drink milk before you have to sing. Highly recommend tea with honey or just water. Yeah. I read somewhere that I think Selena Gomez drank like a bit of olive oil before she sang or something. I don't know, but I think I read that somewhere, but just make sure your throat's like not dry and scratchy. So, am I gonna watch Kingdom? You betcha. You betcha I'm gonna watch Kingdom. Y'all know I did radio with Peniel from B2B at TBS back in the day. Gotta support. So, of course, I'll be checking them out on Kingdom. We mentioned it earlier, actually, in the Clubhouse thing, but I also said to support the boys. So, support the boys in Kingdom and Peniel! Let's go. I'm so excited. Oh my god. Let's see. Easiest choreography I've learned? Out of my choreographies or like cover things, cuz it's a different answer for each one. I want to recommend you to Now United. They're really good. Oh, okay. I will check out Now United. Let's see. Okay, Green Day. Let's see. Favorite childhood anime? The first anime I ever watched was Fruits Basket. The original, not the new one they've made now. I haven't watched it. I don't know if it's the same as the old one or not, but Fruits Basket. That was the first one I watched. And to this day, I still don't know if I'm Team Kyo or if I'm Team Yuki. I still don't know. Like, in the back of my head, I'm like, I'm Team Hatsuharu because cowboy. Like, cow man. Cow man. He's spicy. But I don't know. But can you be my older sister? Absolutely. Cow man. I don't know, I just, comment. I bet your light stick will look sci-fi. I hope it does. Help, why are you so Gen Z? Like, honestly, actually, 90% of my friends are younger than me. So I'm constantly around the Gen Z energy. I mean, me and Jay argued about this with Junie. I think Junie was on the episode with it. And when we were talking about being not millennials, but also not Gen Z. 96 is just a weird year. I don't know. I don't consider myself Gen Z because I grew up with everything millennials did. And because I'm kind of an old soul and how I was raised, I identify more with millennial stuff. But I'm around the Gen Z energy all the time because all my friends are like 98, 99, 2000, 2001. So, yeah. Let's see. They're younger, but they're smaller. Me? My friends are younger, but I am smaller. I am the smallest person in our friend group. It is ridiculous. It's not fair. It's not fair. Let's see. Marry me, Alexa. Guys, I am... marriage difficult. Marriage difficult. I don't want to end up like Adam Driver and Scarlett Johansson. Guys, I can't accept any more marriage proposals right now. Brain too full. Brain full. Brain no room for Mary. Sorry, right now. Ask again next month. Do you listen to Divine? Yes, I do. I actually had a playlist going on yesterday that I was making. But Divine, yes. For those of you who don't know who Divine is, assuming we're talking about the same one, he is an Indian rapper, and if I'm correct, the movie Gully Boy was based off of him. It's pretty badass, but yeah. What the hold? Oh, we're not gonna listen to that song. It is a little too inappropriate for the live. Yeah. Throw it back with this one. Y'all, I love Kesha so much. Guilty pleasure, Kesha. Let's see. Yeah, Gully Boy. I did see Gully Boy, yeah. I'm actually, guys, I think I talk about India like once every VLive, but I have so much genuine interest in India and the culture, the music, like watching films, like having been there like for basically a month span of time before I debuted. Oh my gosh. Because aside from Korea, India was the first foreign country I ever went to. And it was the most breathtaking experience. So I've really fallen in love with many aspects of the country. So I try to stay up to date with artists and music and movies. So somebody's knocking on the neighbor's door. Please don't knock on my door. I'm gonna have a panic attack if I do that, please. Let's see. Can you give me a nickname? Okay, Audrey. Let's see, Audrey. I have a cousin named Audrey. Your nickname is going to be Little Biscuit. I'm sorry. Brain no here. You are Little Biscuit. Let's see. This is a song that was on Victorious. I actually never watched Victorious. Like, all of my friends watched Victorious, and I never did. So when they talk about it, I'm like, I don't know what's going on. I just know that the character Jade is really cool. Yeah, so. But that's how Ariana Grande got her start, if I'm correct. Yeah. I didn't watch this show. I just know bits and pieces about it. Bestie, you a Marvel fan? You know it. You know it. I also heard that characters from the movie Big Hero 6 are now gonna be in a live-action Marvel movie with other people. I don't know. I'm confused. I got my facts twisted, but something. But you're from Pakistan, which is right next to India. Of course I know where Pakistan is. Hello, the Pakistan. Let me see the pants. My lizard says hi. Hi to your lizard. Let's see. Hi, I'm Samantha and I love you. I love you too, Samantha. Let's see. When are you doing another meet and greet? I miss you. I also miss you guys. I want to do another meet and greet. Honestly, if we could like moderate another Clubhouse thing, I think that'd be fun. Wait, oh my god, it's Megan Thee Stallion. Wait, are you talking about, wait, I've seen so many TikToks with using that audio, but it's always, they actually show a horse, but oh my god, it's Megan Thee Stallion. Okay, let's see. Does Wyoming exist, yes or no? Yes, Wyoming exists. I've been to Wyoming. Unless I didn't and we're just living in a simulation, like I'm pretty sure we are living in a simulation. Daft Punk split up. What am I supposed to do with my life? What am I supposed... Okay, more Beetlejuice musical, but this isn't like my favorite song, so we're just gonna... Ooh, Local H's cover of Toxic. A good cover. Speaking of Toxic, free Britney. If y'all don't know what's going on, like, I implore you to look into the situation. Thoughts and prayers to Britney. Free Britney. But, let's see. King Julian, hold on. No, every time, without fail, that I get on TikTok, there's always something, the King Julian impressions, and I'm just like, why is this trending? Why is this trending? But, yeah. Let's see. I know, I miss Daft Punk. Y'all, I grew up with Daft Punk. When I was in show choir, we used Get Lucky as like a cha-cha. Like, y'all, Daft Punk. Valerie, I love you. Valerie, I love you. Let's see. Australia is a hoax. Is Australia real? Is Australia real? Let's see. Oh, my ankle. One second, I gotta stretch my leg out. Hi from Hawaii. Oh my gosh, hello. How is it in Hawaii? It sounds lovely there. Let's see. A day that I will never forget. I want to say when I did camp after I debuted in Singapore. Literally standing on that stage in front of like 10,000 people, bruh, like, I will never forget that. I want to perform in front of a crowd so bad again. Like, I feel really bad for groups that have debuted in the middle of the pandemic because they haven't had a live audience like once. Like, fortunately, when I debuted, I had my music bank and I had Simply K-Pop, and then I went straight to Singapore, so I at least had like live audiences at least three times, and camp was absolutely astounding. That was an incredible time that I'm never going to forget. But now with how everything is in the pandemic, it's like, you know, there's no live audiences, which of course it's for safety, so I would 100% stand by it. I agree with it, but I just wish things would get better, because I trust me when I tell you, we miss performing in front of people. We miss performing in front of people. Like, fortunately, we found things that also give us the opportunity to perform in front of you guys, like, untact, like, online concerts and everything, which is always great. Always a lucky case, incredible to do that. Always grateful if we have those opportunities, but there's just something different about performing in front of live people and getting the energy. Like, Hello from Mexico. Hello. Alexa, I lost 80 pounds. I love you. You lost 80 pounds. Congratulations on the weight loss. Wow. Congratulations. As long as it was done in a healthy fashion, then congratulations. I hope you reach your target weight. Maybe I need some rehab. Or maybe just need some sleep. Yes. Let's see. Your birthday's March 7th. Can you do it live that day? Depending on what my schedule is, I can try. My mom's birthday is March 11th. So we will be celebrating the Pisces season regardless. Yeah. But hello from South Africa. Hello to South Africa. Hello to South Africa. Let's see. What if I make a cover of Rule the World? I can sing it. Sure. Do it. Do it. Give me. Do cover. I want to see. Let's see. Have I seen WandaVision? No, I haven't. I haven't. I've heard a lot about it, though, because my friends are, like, really big, like, Marvel fans. I mean, I am, too, but like, I haven't had time to invest into things recently. But I've heard a lot about it. It seems really intriguing, so I might check it out. But Pisces gang. I am not Pisces, but my mom is Angie. Angelina, she's a Pisces. Same birthday as Rihanna. Ashnikko. Ashnikko is a Pisces. Ashnikko collab. When, please? Yeah. Let's see. I had a feeling you were going to say camp. Honestly, it's just a memory that I really treasure. And I saw that on Twitter, like, a few weeks ago. I think my Dramarama cover started trending around a bit. So I went back to my YouTube and I watched all my performance videos. It's just, that was such a good experience. I want to go back. Let's see. I have school today where you live and it's so late. Oh, really? Well, I mean, it is Thursday. Maybe, is it Thursday for y'all or Wednesday? I don't know which ones of y'all live in the past and which one of y'all live in the future with me. Sometimes I don't know what time zones people are in. Let's see. Thank you. Let me answer this real quick because I need to answer people. Hello? Yo, there's so many, like, noises coming from the apartment today. So many. Sorry, one second. Do-do-do-do. That's, I can't spell. Yes, correct, send? Okay. But, oh. Good song. Let's see. What song do I listen to when I have a hard time? Ah! Yes. Well, lately. No. I've been listening to... I don't know. I feel like I say this a lot when I answer this, but when I'm, like, down, it depends. If it feels like it's a mood that I can get myself out of, I will try to listen to, like, some of my favorite, like, groups of songs, like, songs that get me pumped up, you know, to just change the energy. But if I'm feeling down and I feel like I just need to cry it out, I have a whole playlist of sad songs, and I'll just lay there in bed for hours crying it out, because sometimes that's the most therapeutic thing for me. So, you know, there's no shame in staying sad if you feel sad. Crying things out is perfectly healthy. But, you know, it's also not healthy to linger in it for too long, because... But you can always listen to, like, your lit songs and try to change your mood, or you can cry. I cry a lot. 안녕하세요. 안녕하세요. Let's see. Yeah, she's a carrot. Y'all should know this. Y'all should know this. No, I mean, I see people talk about it, because especially when they're like, oh my gosh, I was with Alexa back when she was just, like, a cover account, and she was a big 17 stan. No, like, I will be honest, I will be frank. idols are all like fans of each other. I really do respect 17, somebody named, a whole lot. Like, they came from like the bottom and now they're like one of the top groups. Such a well-rounded group. Mad talented, mad talenty, like, respect. Let's see. Hello, Ragad? Ragad? Please forgive me if I mispronounce, but hello, Ragad? Let's see. Are you gonna be part of Mindset with Dive? Loki? I kinda want to. I'ma talk to Diane, and if not Diane, I will talk to the Nam Man. But I think it'd be fun. It would be a nice thing for me to do, I think. Any life advice? Life advice in general? Oh, that's a tricky one. That's a slippery slope, she is. Life advice. Make sure, you know, I think I've gotten to a point in my life where, like, I just live for myself. It's like, you know, I do live for other people at the end of the day. But in the back of my mind, I finally have the mindset where it's like, is this gonna make me happy? And it's not selfish to prioritize your happiness. I promise you that. It's something I've learned at the ripe young age of 24, that it's okay to prioritize your own happiness. Like, yeah, I don't know. At the end of the day, you matter. What you think and how you feel matters. And it's important to learn that. So. Let's see. What's the first... Oh, good first job for young adults. Good job. First job. Wow. If y'all were with me in Clubhouse, you can tell today I can't speak for some reason. I couldn't speak yesterday either. Like, yesterday I was speaking Korean and English all day, and it just, my brain said, stop. But a good first job for young adult, a waiter, a host or hostess at a restaurant, the person that seats people. Let's see, I mean, my first job, I was a hostess at a restaurant, and then I graduated to waitress, and then I was also a sushi chef for a point in time, all at the same restaurant. I was a photographer's assistant for a while when I started college. And then I worked at a different restaurant as a sushi chef and waitress. Then I worked at Lush for years. Like, not gonna lie, sales jobs, I would recommend, like, retail. But you gotta have a strong mindset if you're gonna work any kind of retail, baby. Like, Lush technically isn't retail, I guess, because it's not clothes, whatever. But we're selling things and I have to sell them. Like, baby, you need a strong mindset to do retail, because sometimes people just, you know. But, yeah, y'all, wait, did, you know, I feel dumb, because I always assume that everybody knows these things. But yeah, I was a sushi chef for a while, actually. When I was 15 and a half, that's when I first got hired at this restaurant I worked at for, like, years. I literally worked at that restaurant until I was, like, I think about 4 years I worked at the restaurant. But I started as a hostess, made my way up to waitress, and then I became sushi chef. And there's, like, tests you gotta pass, you gotta memorize the roles and everything. And oh my gosh, when we would get slammed, oh my gosh, sushi is one of the most complicated things to make. Like, oh, you miss an ingredient, it's like the roll is off, and it's like, ah! Like, but low-key, it's fun, because I can't really cook, so, like, sushi is, like, I don't know. But the thing is, you gotta, like, have the rice correct, because there's different consistencies of the rice. And then there's, like, it's complicated. And the knife has to be sharp enough to cut through the nori, because sometimes the knife not sharp enough and you have to, like, saw, and you're not supposed to saw when you cut sushi. This is completely irrelevant, but when you cut sushi, you should not, like, saw. You go, like, down, cut. Down, cut. Like, you don't saw it. It tears the roll. Anyways. Anyways. Went on my little sushi tangent there. On the urodo de... I'm gonna cry, stop. Please, don't tell me to cry, because I will. Please cook sushi on Alexa 360. You know what? You know what? I just might. Oh my gosh, it's already been an hour. What do y'all say we make this an hour and a half, It's a Thursday, and you know what that means? Absolutely nothing. I don't know why I titled the VLive that, but yeah, let's see. Sushi trauma. Listen, I have a lot of work trauma I can talk to y'all about. Like, woo! A lot of work trauma. I wound up quitting one job because of racism towards me. So, bye. But, no. I do miss my job at Lush, though. Because, I don't know. It's just, it's nice being around nice smells all day. Like, your mood just stays good. And, like, I was a good salesperson. Like, for any of you who know about Lush, like, the salespeople, we don't get commission or anything. It's like, if I helped you and I made a sale, I wouldn't get commission from the sale. Like, that's not how Lush works. But, like, I was a good salesperson. I typically always got people to buy their things, and I always got them to, like, buy more things, because that's what you do in sales. You push people to buy things. But, yeah. Let's see. Who we gotta kill? Alex? No worries. It's okay. No worries. It's in the past. This song. Let's see. Do music video reactions on Alex 360? Well, I might for, like, you know, like, Latin American artists and everything. I don't really think it would be necessarily appropriate for me to do, like, K-pop reactions, but maybe I could react to people's reactions of me. I'm doing that. Y'all hearing it right now. Whenever my next comeback is, whenever that is, I will watch people's reactions and react to their reactions for Alexa 360, yeah? Let's see. You're doing physics? Oh no. Roman Holiday, let's go! I'm not even joking. This song has been getting me through this week. And getting through the week, y'all. Take a little break. let's see. Gracie Abrams, she does a song, Friend. Yeah, right? I like that song. Sad. But, let's see. Oh, Alexa 360 started on your birthday? Well, I hope that was a good birthday gift for you. Let's see. Me and Link. Oh, Lanky Box. Oh, Adam and Justin. They're such cool dudes. If we could collab again, that'd be fun. But. Bob the Wasp. Hello, wasps. Man, back where I used to live, we had a bad wasp problem. Wasps are scary. Like, yellow jackets, wasps, scary. Let's see. I say let's see a lot, and I say good question a lot. I pick up on that. Okay. Would I like to learn Arabic? Yes, I would really like to, actually. There's so many languages I want to learn, but my brain sometimes she can't even focus with just English, clearly. So, but I feel like being a polyglot, I feel like it would be beneficial for your thought process, I guess, and how you process information. I don't know. I'm just trying to be as multilingual as I can, but my brain, she doesn't want to work. She needs a Roman holiday. Favorite My Little Pony character. I never was into My Little Pony, actually. I know some of the character names, but it wasn't ever my thing. I know that the voice actor... Hold on. Wait. Isn't the voice actor for that one Country Pony the same person that did Sandy from SpongeBob? Or am I wrong? I don't know. But yeah, I was never really a My Little Pony person, I apologize. But the characters are cute, really cute. Let's see. How many languages do I know? Fluently English. Next up, Korean. After that, Spanish. After that, Mandarin Chinese. And then after that, like this much, Japanese. But like, I'm not fluent in Japanese or Spanish or Chinese. I know I can hold a conversation, but like, there's no way I could do an hour-long live in either of those languages. Let's see. Hello, Lana. Lana? Hello? Let's see. Oh my gosh. I am in pain. Oh, good morning. Okay. Let me look through my library real quick and just see what I have because, oh, that's the album. We don't need to play the album. It's a little much. It's a little much if you don't think so. We had some Green Day today. We already had that. Beetlejuice musical. Can't go wrong with that. Wow, my voice. Y'all, the pollution is really bad right now. So I promise I'm not sick or anything. The pollution is just so bad and it just... Yes, my neck snapped. I pop my neck a lot. Bad habit, but yeah. I'm gonna just play Arctic Monkeys. Why'd You Only Call Me When You're High? Because I like this song a lot. I love Arctic Monkeys. I'm invited to the carne asadas. Gracias, gracias. Thank you. Oh my gosh, I want to be invited to the asada. Thank you. You came out as non-binary. Congratulations. One of my dear friends back home is also non-binary, and they are like an absolute, like, royal ethereal human being. I love them with my entire heart. So congratulations. We respect everybody in this family. He, she, they, thems, everybody. Let's see. Can I get a virtual hug? My long arms are embracing you. Why do my arms look so long? Oh, I don't like that. What? Okay, like this is basically my arm length, but if I put it up, they look so long. I don't like that. I do not like that. Bad habit of mine? That's a good question. Saying that, that's a good question. That's a bad habit of mine. Also, popping my knuckles? Bad habit. Popping my neck? Bad habit. I don't know. I make a lot of weird noises. And I'm kind of overly expressive in my face, and sometimes that can be bad. So I guess those are my bad habits. You have 10 in your exam of physics. I don't exactly know what that means, and I don't know if that is good or bad, but exam, yes, good luck, pass. Have I seen 90 Day Fiancé? No, I don't really watch like a lot of reality shows, but I know the jokes from it. I know the jokes from it. But do you like Spanish songs? I do. Let me pull one up. It should be on my, unless I didn't transfer it. I gotta transfer my library. Oh my gosh, it's not. I was gonna play Mon Laferte. Shoot. Well, we'll just play some J. Parvin. So. Avril Lavigne. Yes, Avril Lavigne. Oh my gosh. Avril Lavigne. My emo phase. Yes. Karol G. Yes, Karol G. Yes. Listen. Karol G, Anita, Rosalía, Becky G, Maluma, J Balvin, Bad Bunny, like Pablo Vittar. There's so many artists that I love and would love to collab with, but we'll see. We'll see. Bestie, wanna go to my quinceañera in 2 years? Yes, I would love to go to your quinceañera. I've only been to one, but it was like so much fun. Granted, I was significantly older than the girl whose quinceañera it was, but she was like family friend's daughter, so I was invited and it was fun. You came out as bi. Congratulations. Everybody's coming out today. Congratulations to all of you. Congratulations for having the courage and strength and the love inside of your heart to love yourself and just live your life. Live your truth. Live your truth. Yes. My favorite hair colors that I've done personally, the Mint for Revolution, and then, not gonna lie, the orange for Kitty Run was nice. It was nice, but very hard to get out of my hair. I definitely wanna go red eventually. Yeah. Let's see. This is a revolution, King Juliet! The King Julian stuff, Let's see. Your voice calmed me down from panic attack. Oh goodness. I hope you're okay now. I hope you're safe. Now you're breathing fine, but that's lovely to know. Thank you. I hope that you guys know that y'all help me a lot whenever I'm going through things. But yeah, thank you. I'm glad to hear that. One second. My library, it's not completely transferred from what I have on my phone onto here. Let me play this one song that I really like. It's a Spanish song, but because I didn't transfer my library. I don't know why I didn't transfer my library. Hello? I did not click you. Go away. My search history. Dive Studios, Alexis EB Label, JREKML, followed by Here's to Ronnie and Archie and Betty and Jughead. I was trying to show somebody the video of Riverdale. And then, yeah. It is what it is. Yeah. What was I gonna search? Yes, Mon Laferte. Hello, okay, Mon Laferte, tu falta de querer. Yes, a go. Hello, go. Thank you. Have I seen Avatar The Last Airbender? I grew up watching that show, yeah. You're 12 years old, you keep forgetting that you're younger than me. It's kind of scary. 12-year-old would be watching me. Ooh, scary. But hello, love and respect to my beautiful 12-year-olds. Let's see. Do I know Dynasty? No, I'm sorry. I do not. Someone came in and said, hi! Hi. did you read Hunger Games? Nah, I wasn't a Hunger Games person or a Divergent person. I really wasn't. I saw some of the movies, but I didn't read the books. Come to India again? Definitely. Definitely. Stay safe until then. Take care of yourself. I will definitely come back to India when I can. Of course I know what mariachi music is, of course. I love you, Tuda. Hello to you. You just woke up? Good morning. Good morning. Let's see. Trying to think about what we should do for Alexa 360. I have some ideas. But I know that y'all really want me to do like makeup. So if I were to like sketch out like 3 face charts and like upload them, would y'all like vote on which one you wanted to see me attempt like on a vlog? Cause like makeup's, I like doing makeup. And I've seen a lot of comments actually asking for makeup. I would just need to go get more supplies because I need things, but. Okay, cool. I think if I do the face charts, I think one will be like, I don't know, like glam, my style of like glam looks that I would do. And then one could be like, fantasy makeup, and then if I can find what I need, one could be like special effects makeup, but then again, I don't know what kind of like appliques they have and like what kind of adhesives they have in Korea here, but because I studied special effects makeup in high school and college, so let's see. Of course I watched The Sweet Life of Zack and Cody. I grew up with that show. Let's see. Whew, sorry for yawning, y'all. I'm tired. Wow. My favorite candy? Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. One of my aunties, she recently got me some Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. And I was so happy. So happy. Because the piano jam near me had them for like a week. And then I went back down the other day, and it's just like, they are no more. ¿Por qué? No. ¿Cómo fue? Let's see. Disney or Nickelodeon? I mean, I watched both growing up. Disney, Nickelodeon, Cartoon Network. But like shows that I liked the most, I think they were probably Nickelodeon shows, honestly. Well, I don't know. Oh, hold on, what? This song is good. Thank you, chicken commercial. I'm not gonna buy you chicken. Thank you. But no, because like I watched Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends growing up. I watched The Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy. I wasn't allowed to watch Ed, Edd n Eddy for the longest time because it's just stupid. But when I did sneak around and watch it, I watched that show. What else was there on Cartoon Network? I mean, we all grew up watching like Scooby-Doo, Tom and Jerry, Flintstones. We had like old DVDs of things like The Jetsons, Felix the Cat, Betty Boop stuff, but like Nickelodeon, like Fairly Odd Parents, Courage the Cowardly Dog, that was like one of my favorite shows as a kid. That says a lot now about my adult life, wow. Jimmy Neutron, what else was there? SpongeBob, of course. What else was there? Regular show. See, that's when I started like outgrowing, like watching Cartoon Network. Like I never really watched Regular Show. I didn't really watch Amazing World of Gumball. I've seen a few episodes. I just never like watched it. Adventure Time. Duh. Y'all saw my TikTok. I loved Adventure Time. Love Adventure Time. Danny Phantom. Yes. That also explains a lot of things in my adult life, but. Let's see. Oh, Disney Channel. We had Kim Possible. We had Sweet Life of Zack and Cody. Sweet Life on Deck. Then we had, The Lizzie McGuire Show. That's So Raven. We had Wizards of Waverly Place. Chowder. Oh my gosh, Chowder. Yes. Samurai Jack. Oh my God, yes. Yes. Hannah Montana. Yes. Did you guys know that I think Hannah Montana is based on Dolly Parton? I could be wrong, but I've just seen a lot of theories floating around. I love Dolly Parton so much. That is... Dolly Parton. This song is Amarame by Mon Laferte featuring Juanes. It's... yeah. Amarame. Flapjack! Okay, The Misadventures of Flapjack. That show was so... weird, but like good. Let's see. Cat Dog, A Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Yes, yes, Family Matters. Yes, yes. Full House, Uncle Jesse. Yeah. Let's see. Amo tu español. No, no. Let's see. Anita, yes, of course. I love Anita. Corey in the house. I don't think y'all understand. Y'all know that I'm friends with Corey Corbin from 28 Laboratory. For the longest time, his like contact in my phone, I had it as Corey in the house. But now it's Corbin. Corbin in the lab of 28. Okay, commercial. I'm gonna just play this last song. And then I'm gonna go because... my ankle hurts, and yeah, because it's been almost a minute, hour 30 at this point. Let's see. See, I didn't watch Shake It Up, though. I didn't watch Shake It Up, but I know that's, like, where Zendaya and, like, Bella Thorne got their start. I love Zendaya so much. Let's see. Your new name is Ruin. I'm honored to know your new name, and that's a really cool new name, my friend. That is an incredible new name. Wow, the pollution is incredible today. I should buy an air purifier. Good Luck Charlie. I never watched it a lot, honestly. I knew about it because of Bridget Mendler. But I never really watched it. Let's see, don't forget to drink water. Thank you. Again, I assure you guys I'm fine. It's just the pollution's been really bad. Wow, and I've been talking for a long time today so far. And you'd think that walls and windows keep pollution out. They don't. Let's see, can we hold hands? Give me hand. I want to hold hand. I have not held a hand in 4 years. Please, hold hand. Thank you. Can you touch your cheek? I touch. Let's see. Hold your hand back. Thank you, Alexa the Bestie. Let's see. Big Time Rush. I watched the show, but it wasn't like something I religiously watched. Like, I watched it when I did, so. Don't dance on your ankle until it recovers, please. I'm trying not to do anything, but hopefully by next week it should be okay. But who knows? I don't know. Oh, so your quinceañera is March 13th. Let me just yeet out of here real quick and go to your quinceañera. Can I have a high five? Meh. Food cravings these days? Canes, chicken, Raising Canes? Raising Canes. Weirdly enough, this pho and spring rolls that I had in the mall that I worked at, when I worked at Lush, they had a kiosk and it was like Vietnamese food, but like the spring rolls? The pho? Really nice. Kind of missed that for some reason. I miss Sonic. Y'all, I miss Sonic for no good reason. I miss Sonic. I miss dill pickles. Really weird to say that, but dill pickles. They don't have dill pickles in restaurants in Korea. Like when you order something like and it comes with pickles, it's like the sweet ones. I can't eat those. I cannot eat those. But Sonic, Chick-fil-A, yeah. Let's see. Okay, song is gonna end, so I'm gonna end the live because my iPad's almost dead, my ankle hurts, and I gotta get on with my day because I got a schedule and my voice is getting scratchy from talking and pollution. Let's see, I'm just read like two more comments before I go. Let's see. Rate fans pets on Alexa 360. Okay, you know, we could do that. We could probably open up like an email and like you submit pictures of your pets. Yeah, that might be fun. It's like, I rate your pet. How much of a good boy is your dog? How majestic is this cat? How incredible is your bird? I might just do that. That sounds interesting. That sounds fun. Let's see. Bestie, tengo sueño. Gracias. Okay. Let's see. One more comment before I go. Let's see. When in doubt, just clack the nails because that just makes it up for it. Let's see. This is my first V Live of yours that I watched, and I already missing last part of the sentence, but this is your first V Live. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for joining me on the V Live today. I hope that you make some new friends after this V Live is over. Yeah, enjoy your stay. It's a nice little family we have going on. Thank you guys for joining me on Clubhouse today, right now on V Live. Please check out the video that I did with Sunny. There's one up on my channel, and then I believe one is going up on her channel at 8 p.m. KST. So basically in about 3.5 hours, a video is going to go up on her channel that we did. Again, tremendous shout out to Alexis and Lai for hosting me on Clubhouse, and tremendous shout out to Sunny for collabing with me. And we got stuff coming for you real soon. Keep your eyes peeled. There's a lot that we're working on, actually, and I think you'll be quite surprised with what some of it is. So I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Let me turn this off now. Okay, I end now. Yes.